going to go ahead and assume that it's running.
Hey, and welcome to Science Alert's new YouTube show, where we're going to promote the science behind some of the very most popular links that we feature on Science Alert. We bring you a ton of information every week, but sometimes we want to bring you a little bit more. We want to get a little bit more in depth with respect to certain stories. And so I'm here to help you along with that. My name is Karen. I am a biologist with a twist, and sometimes that twist most genuinely refers to a good old-fashioned twist of lime in a gin martini. But also the twist kind of refers to the fact that a little kooky, a little off the beaten track as far as the normal career of a scientist goes, and I'm happy to be bringing you all of these cool links from Science Alert. So let's go ahead and get started. One of our most popular link stories from October so far has been that of the bacterial alchemy. Scientists looking at liquid gold, which is actually gold chloride, an extremely, extremely toxic substance, realize that bacteria can live here. And not only can they live here, but they can metabolize the gold chloride and create golden nuggets out of it. I mean, it's not really that surprising that bacteria can live in extreme environments. Acidic environments, extremely salty environments, extremely cold or extremely hot environments. There's even bacteria that can live in environments where they're being radiated all the time. They're being hit with radiation that's basically spewing out their DNA. Bacteria, some of them have the ability to bring it all back together. Now, this was part of an art installation that took place out of the University of Michigan earlier this year, and it's actually cost prohibitive to use this for any kind of a real alchemy perspective. So nobody's actually going to be getting rich off of this, but just the mere fact that bacteria have the ability to do this and to live in this environment is extremely humbling. I mean, you know, the next time a meteor hits Earth and all the humans and other big helpless mammals are gone, bacteria are just going to be like, nah, whatever, just another day at the office. Now, the black mamba snake is extremely venomous. You get bitten by one of these guys and it's like night-night unless you can get some anti-venom pretty darn fast. Researchers have recently discovered that one very small portion of the venom of the black mamba contains a compound that has anti-pain properties or pain-killing properties, very similar to something like morphine. But the interesting and perhaps best part about this is that morphine is part of a class called opiates or opioid drugs, and there's opioid receptors in the brain that look exactly like this. And these receptors are what basically creates the side effects of these drugs. So the nausea, the decreased breathing capabilities, and of course the addiction. So the opioid receptors are something that this new drug completely misses. No receptors there, and basically treats the pain without creating any kind of side effects. So this could be extremely valuable for the medical field. I mean, let's face it, somebody is gonna get a beach house and a boat and a whole bunch of things over this. They do have it patented, by the way. This is, of course, not the first time that natural compounds have been found to cure some kind of ailment in the human animal. This happens all of the time. Taxol, a very, very popular cancer drug, comes from the Canadian yew tree. Another kind of cancerous drug is being developed from sea squirts or tunicates, one of our very closest relatives in the invertebrate world, I might tell you. An anti-HIV drug was found in some rainforests that were nearly completely devastated before the compound was found. Very interesting examples of where conservation meets medicine, meets biochemistry. Let's make sure that we don't destroy all these environments before we found the chemicals that could help us in the long run. Of course, because everything is all about us all the time. Really, unless there's a human element to it, why keep it around? Okay, so this year's Nobel Prize in Physics went to two independent researchers, Serge Haroche and David Wineland, for their work on particle control in a quantum world. Each of these researchers independently came up with ways to manipulate and measure particles without compromising their quantum mechanical nature. Yeah. What does that even mean? Luckily, we all had the wonderful Minute Physics to turn to, who created a video about this exact topic, and it was one of our most popular hits on Science Alert this fall.
So in order to see light, we need to use non-destructive testing. One way of doing that is to make a super dark, super cold box and cover the inside with a really, really shiny mirror. A mirror so excellently reflective that photons of light bounce back and forth more than a billion times before being absorbed. In that time, they'll travel a distance equivalent to one trip around the Earth. This box is also so cold and dark that only occasionally will there even be one photon inside. And if there is one, how do we tell without destroying it? Well, we send an atom through the box, an atom in a superposition of two different atomic states, just like Schrodinger's cat. If there's no photon inside the mirror box, then when the atom comes out the other side, we'll most likely measure it as being in a certain one of the states. Let's call it dead. But if there is a photon in there, and we carefully send the atom through so it doesn't actually destroy the photon, the atom-photon interactions change the odds. So now it's an overwhelming chance that we see that atom as alive.
Another really popular story that came to us this fall was that of the super strawberries. The University of Queensland has an agriculture program that has been breeding strawberries for a number of years. And we're not talking about doing anything that's moving genes or inserting genes or creating things in a mechanical sense. We're talking about moving genes the old-fashioned way. If you have a dog, you'll be looking at one of the most extreme examples of an artificial selection experiment that's on the planet Earth. Basically, every species of dog was selected for, you know, long bodies, big hair, big teeth, whatever. All of these traits can be selected for by mating one kind of dog with the other. This is basically what's happened at the University of Queensland, and they found a kind of strawberry that has an increased amount of anthocyanins, which is a pigment, very healthy, anti-cancerous, anti-inflammatory, anti a whole bunch of things. And these anthocyanins are extremely concentrated in this one strain of strawberry. This could be very, very powerful for farmers who can charge more money for these super happy strawberries, and also very powerful for a consumer who can get a lot healthier by eating a fruit that's extremely high in vitamins. So I'm going to round out the program by showing you our top three images from the fall so far. These need no explanation. I'm just going to shut up and let you chill out and enjoy them. Okay, so that about does it for the first episode of this One Step Further Behind the Scenes Science Show with Science Alert. Let us know what you think. Let us know what other stories you would like to see covered in a little bit more detail, especially some of your favorites from the Facebook page. We look forward to hearing from you, and I will see you at the next time. Ciao.